In this video, we are going to talk about some of the concepts in Chapter 2. So we're going to start out by creating a very simple program which demonstrates the different data types. And I am going to assume that you're going to read about the order of precedence and how arithmetic calculation is being done. But I want to create a project. Here, let's go File, New. I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to call this, I'm going to make sure it says Visual C++ Win32 Console Application, and it's going in my Visual Studio 2013 this time, and I'm going to call it Module 2, and I'm going to put all my Module 2 files under this project, and I'm going to say OK, and I want to say Application Settings, Empty project, and finish. Okay, now we create a new item under source files. I'm going to add a new item, and we're going to create a CPP file, and I'm going to call it data types. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to show you just all the different data types that can be created. So I'm going to add a comment that says this program demos simple data types and how to read and output them. Okay, so we have our standard IO stream. Also going to include strings, so I can use that. First we need using namespace std int main, and so we're going to start out by creating some integers. Let's say int num1 equals 5, num2 equals 10. So integers are whole numbers. Then we're going to have some float dnum1 or fnum1, say, equals 1.45, and fnum2 equals 2.345, something like that. And let's see, you can have some doubles. Let's have a char answer equals, and notice how I initialize all my variables. If you don't want to initialize it to something specific, and if you don't know, I would initialize, for example, a character to a space, and numbers to zeros if you're not sure what they're going to be. And let's also have a string name. And if you're going to initialize a string, it should be initialized inside of double quotes, a blank inside of a double quote. There, so all our initializations are done, all our variable declarations, that's what they are. So the first thing we do is declare our variables. Then, since we already have values in them, you can output them or you can read them from the user. So we're going to say cout, enter. We have two integers, or I'm going to say two whole numbers. And maybe we will calculate the sum. And semicolon, cin, can read it into num1 and num2, just like that. So when you're going to read two whole numbers like that, you're going to tell them enter two whole numbers, maybe say separated by a space. So now it's really very clear to the user as to how they need to enter the numbers. Then let's say cout, enter two real numbers like that, and we'll do something with them. Cin fnum1 and fnum2. And so here are some, as you write code, you figure out some advantages and disadvantages as to reading numbers like this on one line. or you can read them on separate lines to make it easy for the user. So we can do enter a real number, and maybe we read only fnum1 first, and then I can say cout enter another real number, and you can read that into fnum2. Now notice, as I write this code, I'm going to tell you some of the things, some of the mistakes that students commonly make. If you try to add an end line to your cin, notice what happens. It says, nope, I don't know what this is. So the end line is a manipulator, which we'll talk more about in chapter 3, works only for cout and not for cin. So you can use it with cout, but not with cin. So we need to take it out, otherwise it's not going to like it. All right, so we're done reading the next real number. Then let's ask the user, are you ready for your result? And we will have them enter a character. We call it answer. So read it just like you answer your, just like you read your integer. Let's also ask them, enter your name before they do that. And then you're going to read it into our string name. Now we are going to put it all together, calculate the result and output. Okay, so let's do some calculations. So we are going to say num1 and num2. We said we would give them the sum. We are going to add the two. With the two real numbers, we can do some other operation, and we can output it. So let's see if we can output it as we calculate. So you're going to say cout. Let's first say hello. And let's output their name. So hello is a string. Then you put another extraction operator and their name that we read. And then if you want to put in a couple of more exclamation, we do that. Then let's put a new line. Okay, so now we have output our welcome message. Then we are going to say sum of the two whole numbers equals, so that's what's going to get output as is, sum of the two whole numbers equals, and now I'm going to find the sum, num1 plus num2, and after that I want a new line. Then I'm going to say, maybe let's find the difference of the two real numbers equals, and another extraction operator, and I'm going to say fnum1 minus fnum2, and end line. And that's it. That's all we have. And you really haven't used the char answer, but that's okay. So with that, let's say return 0 and finish our program and see what this does so far. So what we have done is we have declared a few different data types, integers, floats, you can make that doubles, and see what you get as far as the answer goes, a char variable and a string variable. And we've read all that from the user, we've done some calculations, and we've output them. Notice we've done the calculations and we really haven't stored the result. So after this statement, our sum is lost. So if we need it, we need to store it. So let's do function or F7 to build it. Let's actually go here, Control Shift B. Okay, so let's build it. And then let's run it. And it says enter two whole numbers separated by a space, or you can do enter 3 and 4, enter real number 2.34, enter another real number 1.23. Are you ready for your result? I'm going to say yes. It says enter your name. So I'm going to enter my name. And it says hello and my name, sum of the two whole numbers. It gives me the sum, the difference. It gives me the difference. And it is done. That's all we have in our program. Now you could try a few other operators here. You could try the division operator and see how that works. Let's try the division operator. So I'm trying the division operator here, where it says the sum of two whole numbers. So I'm kind of going to change that program to, instead of sum, I'd say the quotient of the two whole numbers. Okay, so let us see what that does. Now I am going to enter two whole numbers. So we are doing a division. I'm going to enter 3 and 4 and then two real numbers. It doesn't matter because it's still going to do our difference. Yes, I'm ready for my result. I enter my name and notice it says the quotient of the two whole numbers is 0. So the two numbers 3 and 4 are integers, and when you divide it you get a 0 because the decimal gets truncated. This is something very important for you to remember as you go through and do the rest of your chapters. So now what do I do if I want to see the result in decimal? Here's something you could do. You could take this num1 and you could cast it. Casting means to change the data type. So I could say static underscore cast to a float. I want to change it to a float just for that calculation. So static cast float. So do look up the syntax or look at my code here carefully. And then let's run the same program. Let's put in 3 and 4. And the real numbers, let's just put in two real numbers. Yes, I'm ready for my result. And notice now I get the quotient of the two whole numbers is 0.75. So I would try different things with this file. Change a few things and see what you get. That is really the key to writing more programs, is to take it and make changes, break it, and try to fix it.